In this episode of Star Hopping with Kissimmee Park Observatory, we'll look at the Orion region and show you how to find these beautiful deep sky objects. The Great Nebula in Orion. The Zeta Orionis region. And the Emission Nebula Messier 78. All right, let's go star hopping. Star hopping. Star hopping. Star hopping. Hey, hello, hi, and welcome to episode 6 of Star Hopping with Kissimmee Park Observatory. I'm Dave Hearn, and I'm absolutely ecstatic to be your host. In this series of programs, we'll show you the most beautiful sights in the night sky and explain exactly how to find them with your binoculars or your telescope. In this episode, we'll be exploring what is most probably the second most well-known constellation in the sky, right after the Big Dipper. We're talking about the constellation of Orion, hanging low in the eastern sky in mid-November about 10:30 p.m. Packed with no less than 7 stars brighter than second magnitude, it's the most prominent constellation in the late autumn and winter skies. Additionally, it's loaded with spectacular deep sky objects of several types. Let's look at this extremely conspicuous constellation. Orion is a hunter, complete with a sword, a club, and a bow. The hunter figure is framed by 2 stars that form the shoulders, with the stars Betelgeuse and Bellatrix, and the 2 stars that mark the feet, Rigel and Saiph. Betelgeuse and Rigel are both in the top 10 brightest stars list, with Betelgeuse shining orange at magnitude 0.6 and Rigel shining blue at magnitude 0.3. Above the shoulder stars is a group of 3 stars that form the eyes and mouth in the head of the hunter. Above the head to the left are 2 lines of stars that form the club in the right upraised hand of the hunter. And to the upper right is an arc of stars that form the bow in the raised left hand. Not sure how he could be wielding 2 weapons at the same time, but hey, the ancients were imaginative. At the center of the constellation is the most prominent feature, the famous Belt of Orion, formed by the 3 brightest stars, Alnitak, Alnilam, and Mintaka. Hanging off the belt is Orion's sword, delineated by a string of stars, all enshrouded in nebula. Here in the sword lies the greatest jewel of all deep sky objects. The number one celestial target for beginning astronomy enthusiasts is undoubtedly the Great Nebula in Orion, Messier 42. This incomparable deep sky object is the largest and brightest nebula that can be seen from the northern hemisphere. It is easily seen with the naked eye as a fuzzy star and takes on a swirly, misty appearance in binoculars. When you point your telescope to this wondrous object, you'll see 2 misty wings stretching out from the bright center with knots and swirls throughout the complex. In the largest of amateur telescopes, the nebula appears pastel green with other hints of blues and pinks. No other nebula in the sky will exhibit color in the eyepiece like this. Also immediately apparent is the group of 4 bright stars lying in the center of the complex, known as the trapezium. These extremely hot stars are very young, recently born out of the nebular gas and dust, and are responsible for lighting up the entire nebula. The trapezium is a great test of your telescope's resolving power, and will also test your eyes. 4 stars are almost immediately visible, but under excellent seeing conditions with dark skies and with a very well-aligned telescope, 5 or 6 can be seen on rare occasions. The Orion Nebula is probably the most viewed object at public observing sessions, as it is easily seen by anyone and impresses even the most surly teenagers. Well, I could spend the entire episode discussing M42, but we have several more amazing targets to discuss. Very close by, there are several other amazing targets. Let's move up to the Belt of Orion and look at the lowest star, Alnitak, also known as Zeta Orionis. Just below Zeta is another large emission nebula called the Flame Nebula. This nebula is difficult to see in the eyepiece because of the close proximity of Zeta. The trick to see this object is to move the bright star just out of the eyepiece field of view and then use averted vision to look for the nebula. This is another amazing nebula in astrophotos. Just a few degrees below Zeta also lies the famous Horsehead Nebula. Unfortunately, unless you have a very large telescope, 20 inches or larger, it is extremely difficult to see visually, even with special bandpass filters. But in photos like this one from KPO, the Horsehead is an amazing object. It's formed by some obscuring dust called a dark nebula that lies in front of the red Emission Nebula behind it. Where the object's names come from is pretty obvious. Our last target for this episode is also right in the neighborhood. We're going to search out Messier 78, another Emission Nebula. To find this puff of nebulosity, we will again start from Zeta Orionis. Ready? This is a simple one. About 5 degrees to the left, there is a fifth magnitude star, 56 Orionis. Draw an imaginary line between Zeta and 56. Move your scope to almost exactly halfway along this line, and M78 should come into view. This is not a terribly bright nebula, glowing in magnitude 8.3, but you should be able to see it fairly easily in a low-power eyepiece. The Orion region reveals its beauty in wide-field astrophotos like this one from KPO. You can see the area is just loaded with nebulosity. An extremely large feature is called Barnard's Loop, which is this large arc below the main body of the constellation. This is also an Emission Nebula. It's part of the Orion Molecular Cloud Complex, which contains all of these other objects. So we started off with the Orion Nebula, and then we moved up to the star Zeta Orionis in the belt, where we checked out the Flame Nebula and the Horsehead Nebula. Finally, we moved up above Zeta and found ourselves Messier 78, a small Emission Nebula. I hope you've enjoyed star hopping around the Milky Way. We'll continue to bring you these astronomy tutorials every couple of weeks, and if we get inspired, sometimes more often. They'll be designed to help you find deep sky objects that are up in the sky around the time that we post them to YouTube. If you found this video useful, please consider subscribing to our channel down there, click the thumbs up, and please share it out to your friends who are looking at stars. Please feel free to leave a question or a comment below, and we'll be sure to respond very quickly. Also, please follow KPO on Facebook, where we post all of our astrophotos and keep everyone informed about upcoming astronomical events. We'd love to hear from you to discuss all this great stuff up in the sky. All the links to these places, including our website, kpobservatory.org, can be found below in the episode notes as well. And finally, if you feel this video provides you value and you'd like to see more, please consider supporting us on Patreon, where for a couple dollars per video, you can support our efforts and let us make even more great astronomy tutorials like this one. Well, thanks again for watching, and we'll see you next time on Star Hopping with Kissimmee Park Observatory.